They don't touch the beef, they don't touch anything. I'm telling you, because I'm trying to change what they do in Asia for 3 years, and I can't. And that's what they want. So, in my case, it's difficult to do that with a cannula, because I try to give more of a projection and definition to the tip, and then, yes, to get some height, but the height I do with a needle, so it takes more time, because I go point by point by point. For me, the nose is very different than any other area, and it's more dangerous, okay? In her case, she doesn't have any surgeries, previous surgery, so it's okay, but you have certain rules, and it's difficult because you have to think about the nose, not with volume, just, it's not about volumization. It's about proportional ratios and angles. It's the perfect features have to do with the angles and the ratios and the proportions between one part of the nose to the other. If not, if they don't match, they don't match. Okay, so. The other thing that I use, different, because is light. Light reflection is very important for me as a way to know if the nose is straight or not straight, it has shadowing or not shadowing. So I use light all around the face. I have a whole talk of half an hour about light, reflection of light, and how we interpret light in our brains. The third one is that I use the surgical concept for non-surgical great results. That's the title of my talk. And it means that whatever I would have done in surgery, I will do it non-surgical. So if you tell me what I would have done with a rhinoplasty, I would have taken some cartilage, which is probably if she had it in the septum, if not from the ear, or if not from her rib, and put it here on the nose. That's what I would have done. But